and insurance for solar.
Hello everyone, my name is Kelly Dupuy, and and on behalf of our research team, we would like to present you our paper entitled Cultural and Religious Status of the Greek Communities in Asia Minor. The content of this study is the surviving Greek cultural heritage in Turkey, focusing on the historical forms of housing concerning the contemporary provinces of Balikesir, Kufa, and Smyrna. The paper consists of an introduction to the general theory of meanings of common house, presentation of the case studies afterwards, analysis of their morphological structural characteristics and transformations, ending up in an evaluation of dwelling perspectives. The aim of our study is the investigation of housing perspectives emerging from the study and enhancement of the Greek historical, cultural and physical status, and more specifically, of those of the surviving buildings of the former Round settlements. Methodology consists of general application bibliography as well as specialized bibliography and in situ research. Research has been taking place in the framework of a research program entitled Cultural and Linguistic Status of the Greek Communities in Asia Minor. Results are conducted after information editing and estimation. In introduction, we refer to the terms of common house as expressed throughout architecture in various ways and are directly related to culture, defining the history of the place. Their equal role as an emergent factor of memory and civilization is approached through historical and architectural registration of several settlements in the region of Asia Minor with prominent Greek cultural presence. As a key study, they were chosen Marmaras and Egypt communities, Thalia and Doma, Cesmena and Otsadi, with morphological differences on both historical and architectural level. The dimension of history in all these cases pre-exists in their current acoustic fabric and features new places revealed from it, redefining the meaning of common house. Following, there is a map indicative of the case studies, where you can see that in the north there is the area of Musa and Balikesir, and in the south there is the region of Izmir. Historically, the common element of the communities that are used in the paper is that most of the inhabitants were allocated during the First World War. As geographical data indicates, Moudania is a coastal town in the southeast of Proconvis and belongs to the region of Boussa. Next to Moudania is Thrillia, a seaside village in the area of Ancient Bithynia. Both of them share much in common. Marmaras, the capital of the homonymous island, located on the southwest coast and is a settlement with abundant vegetation. Ketintik, a city in the western area of Pandrima, in the part that connects Xanakale and Tete, and last, the Rabunumina Peninsula, known also as Ethrea, is in the western part of Izmir, where three of the major towns are, Cesmena, Tzadi and Rula. The geographical and morphological structure of the districts was altered after the migrations that took place during the 19th and 20th century, revealing various sites of the urban fissure. As for characteristics and housing qualities of these areas, the dwelling, from a sociologist's point of view, played a non-standard role in the formation of room social life as a confined space where all families' everyday life took place, establishing their environmental behavior. The Greek dwelling now refers to the genus logi, or the spirit of topos, a phenomenon that is easily perceived by the typological and morphological features. All of these differ from place to place, and all of these have been determined through years by resident necessities, leading to the identification of the term home as an experiential expression and the term house as a structural expression. The architectural features of the buildings in the above settlements comply basically with the standards of traditional architecture, but there can be distinguished details that vary from place to place, bearing emphasis from Western European architecture, ancient past, and not the classic kitchen approaches. Differences identified in terms of topology and morphology are subtle, common due to the special coexistence of fraternities building. The selection of the reference building was made after scientific study on bibliography and civil research and correlation of the data that derived in a combination with the oral testimonies from which scientific study.
Getting on with the general structural characteristics of the buildings, we could say that the materials used in these buildings are stone on the ground floor or the entire building, seen in the southwest coast of Asia Minor, and wood on the upper floor, like a mixed technique, seen on the northern coast of Asia Minor. On the morphological level, there are projected bars on the floors at Nisan, Chikma, alongside the facades or in L shape, and overhanging roof patterns. Buildings can bear also small balconies, the neoclassical expression, or they can bear a solid facade without any extension, like the trade or the agricultural expression. Most houses are two-storied, consisting of the following interior organization: the ground floor and the intermediate spaces serve as auxiliary and catering rooms, kitchen and storage areas. And in the upper floor or floors, we have the living rooms and space for relaxation, bedrooms and others, and the jacuzzi sofa in Turkish. The typology of sofa that's distinguished in most segments is the one of the interior, with variation of shapes, elongated or cross-shaped, and all these above create a layout of the floor plan, symmetric or asymmetric. And at last, the decoration constitutes the absolute reflection of resident status. As we can see from the photos, there have been distinguished elements from the ancient past as a new classical expression with several pilaster, decorative opening frames, skylights, pediments, etc. Or from Byzantine era, signing on frescoes, inscriptions, or interior frescoes of agricultural or nautical interest that reveal either the owner's name or the occupation. Getting on with building transformations, there has been followed an analysis concerning the settlement structure comprehension. So, the housing term has been approached firstly on unit level and secondly on residential level. In unit level, the buildings are categorized below as buildings ruins with partial or complete recreation sections, buildings hybrid with structures of multiple heterogeneous elements, like new outlets, scheme, rough traditional constructions, static buildings, as we call them static because are residential buildings, bearing the memory of old, in fair condition, and buildings, monuments of ancient glory. And of course, mutual buildings that are partially or fully restored. There occurs a new allegorical relationship between the existing fabric, the contemporary one, and the one that's created from all those ruins, and the absence of fabric partitions, as reflected in the building reserve and conveyed through architectural and cultural elements of the regions. In this plan, this is a sample of our scientific team work, which depicts this topographic plan where all these characteristic fields are cited. In this context, on the residential level, the buildings of the new tissue, the historical one, are detected in full consistency or integration with the existing one, solid facades that follow the flow of the existing buildings, or in prominent locations at the corner of building blocks or on elevated points, and in amphitheatrical position, playing the role of terraces and highlighting the bioclimatic qualities of traditional architecture, given the proper building proportions, orientation, absolutely the creation with the topography and the materials of construction, or they are in variation to the existing one, or in contrast to the current issue in terms of architectural style and scale, heights and facades. Dwelling perspectives. Moving on, the understanding and evaluation of sense of the past from the genius loci are once the most determinant means of the perception of architectural space. The architect, academic and artist Dimitris Kikyonis strongly supported the continuity of authentic tradition and sense of historic memory in architecture, accentuating the architectural form as a work of memory and amnesia as well. The protection, so in this sense, an enhancement of the pre-existing forms of historic architecture is of great importance in order to enter the holistic composing and designing process. Below there is presented a series of strategic solutions or proposals. So the efforts for the sustainable management of monumental heritage beyond borders should be promoted bilaterally based on the following: the correct knowledge of space, historical and geographical, the registration of areas of interest and reference, and the realistic search and application of planning scenarios. It remains to be seen that the value of this heritage of Greek communities contributes towards the promotion of cultural tourism in terms of culture and economy. Specifying the above, in our next level, we suggest a series of proposals relating to the institutional and designing level. Declaration of historical science, adoption of international important degrees in areas with extensive or intensive tourism activity, promotion of financial implementation programs, direct cooperation of multiple state and non-state actors, removal of bureaucratic constraints, and notice of international architectural competitions. On urban level, we propose the separation of residential areas, commerce, tourism, industry, with intermediate zones, like buffer zones, as well as the enhancement of acoustic heritage reclaim. And on architectural design or landscape design level, we propose the promotion of transitional neighborhoods by designing historical promenades, enhancing spaces, topos of experience and memory, as well as the promotion of housing conservation and restoration programs with a view of reuse. And as last, connection of historic building use with the current social life of each settlement. Concluding, the part is constructed by the present and analyzed through the future, and this achieved almost a re-examination of historic relations and size. It's obvious that the redefinition of bricks buildings through research redefines the meaning of housing, demonstrating the dialectical relationship between presence and absence, old and new, ruined and restored. Assuming even that memory is preserved not only in time, but also through integrated process of redesign and reconstruction, a series of plans has to be taken. And at this extent, we believe that projects of bilateral interest contribute to the promotion of cooperation with Turkey, as it's our ongoing program. And one last word. The spirit of placeness, the perception of intense memory and localism in Greek heritage, the duality of common house, the extension of historic built environments in case studies described above, constitute all these crucial matters that one has to take under consideration when evaluating the necessity of presenting this heritage and treasures. Thank you.
My name is Serena Sai, I'm coming from Italy, and my paper is a part of my PhD research, just discussed, developed in a doctoral program in architectural design in Florence, about Byzantine Constantinople, Istanbul, for frame of general ideas, the study case of Selçuk Dem. Selçuk Dem constantly wondered about the work on the building type of the Turkish house. Turkish house, our circumstruction, is an open question, as the nature of ten Turkish employed by the Europeans to indicate the culture and the religious ethnicities of the heterogeneous population of the Ottoman Empire. It then worked about the Byzantine influence and wondered what contamination and suggests the Ottoman may have found before becoming Turks. Due to the Greek building of the past remaining standard as a sort of footprint in the statistical design of the city, due to that manner of constructing the Waterfall, the imperial palaces, remains in the history of the identity of the building on the Bosphorus, maybe there is an hidden text in the design of the city. At the time the Kashgar came to Istanbul and were fascinated with its palaces, there were many magnificent yali in Venice, made in the Byzantine style. Four or five of them still remain, but there is one to be seen in Istanbul. The architectural style of this yali in the form of semi-palaces was Byzantine. It's certain that with these endeavors and with this design on the new array on the Bosphorus, Eldem contributed in a decisive manner to the memory and the acknowledgement of the highly particular value of this architectural heritage. The Ottoman house exists for a time as a result of a refined domestic culture suspended between Europe and Asia. After the dissolution of the Ottoman Empire, housing in the Ottoman land manifests a variety of interpretations of the Turkish vernacular type as part of the Ottoman heritage. The tendencies in these new countries was to assert, to absorb, and even to identify themselves with this heritage. Architect in the way of the classical Alte Meister is Selçuk Dem. Is an architect like Palladio, like Friedrich Schink. Like this Alte Meister, all the architectural drawing by him, all the photo, all the sketch, all the surveys, all the book by him are devoted to the construction. The collected surveys of the Bosphorus seaside of the Turkish house are never a catalog. He never played the role of a critic, not that of a poor watcher. He's always involved from inside the architecture to set in a frame for several parts of the town, or a building, or a landscape. The copybook of the booklet for Mirimi Mari are the building material for the following work, not only for him, but for a generation as architect. Not far from the parallel research which, in the same time, an Italian architect as Giuseppe Pagano is conducting, try to contrast the stupidity of the rhetorical regime architecture, searching the true national popular origins, not in a vernacular way, but seeking greatness and nobles in the form of the poor peasant official houses. In the main work of Selçuk Dem, the house is the heart of his long life experience. Between the line of his masterwork, Turk Heavy, we may see as the Turkish house is not only an Anatolian type, but also a way of life common to the wide extension. From Tunis to Lahore, through Baghdad and Cairo, we may understand in which way this architectural type declined itself in the different countries that he had passed through. His role as surveyor of ancient complex, his role trying to establish a net of correspondence from the most various countries, from Pakistan to Serbia, from Tunisia to Odessa, investigating the range and the latitude of the so-called Ottoman house. Sedat Kildem always lived from the experience of the town and from the landscape and conceived his work as a link between research, professional work and teaching. Until the last sketch, until the last class, the last elevation, Sedat Kildem is learning investigation by drawing, asking by drawing the size and the measurement of the sky. In the index of the Turkish House of Farbod books are announced, but the last two, Romanian House and Anatolian House, were unpublished. Probably the draft material still exists. We have recognized the contact with Zamoraki on the Balkan houses, who Sedat Kildem asked books on Serbian and Balkan houses. In the same way, it is to be investigated the link with Tunisia, Jacques Revol, and with Greece or France, where Sedat Kildem is interested to specific houses, as in Cairo and in Pakistan. It's possible to follow the book and discover the themes, the palaces or analogies studied by Sedat Kildem. The net is setting on is composed by highly qualified researchers, engaged intellectuals who work in their own country on the vernacular architecture and on the various candidates in which the Ottoman house was interpreted and not only. Edem is involved to understand the border and the extension of a building type, the range of variation on the themes. Sedat Kildem investigated the Turkish house through the elements that form this type. The garden is part of the home, and every Turkish house was in them as some little piece of nature. Working for an analogy, Sedat Kildem looked for the traces of Turkish gardens in the Great Oriental Garden, like Shamdar Garden in Lahore, and in the gardens of Isfahan and Kabul. Sedat Kildem for the house talk about a mission which inhabited itself the lifelong. In the Sedat Kildem architecture, the experience of Turkish house is building material and the element characterizing the Turkish type as the sofa were element to reinvent a new idea of life in the contemporary society. This is particularly evident in Ermadag apartment, where the senior shape of a traditional fireplace is the occasion to let flex the usually flat vertical external wall. And this is all far from the vernacular ways of using the past, but considering cultural heritage and landscapes as a living energy for the project. Oti begins with Amsterdam Eusebianism, which can be defined the archetype of this kind of building. The building which can now be seen on the Bosphorus near Anadolu Isari is only a fragment of the original and elaborated plan of the Samurai State, organized according to the usual disposition in ceramic and aramic. All that remains of this constellation of architectural elements is the building with a central plan which rotates about a fire, while around the Dylan Honey, a great room made up of a low seat placed under the window that repeatedly opened onto the sea. All come from Orient, wrote Luciano Semerani. But in this building on the Bosphorus, all is still manifest. In fact, it remains throughout the century as an incorporator of Ottoman architectural art. From the archetype to the realization of a modern interpretation of this residence on the Bosphorus, and then find itself with the opportunity to design a new Yale on the Bosphorus. Although this commission engaged them for individual building, at a certain point the dynamic becomes so great that the context could no longer to be defined to the site of each yard. It inevitably becomes a moral question, or rather the image of this canal of the Bosphorus through a reconstruction of fragments of the two banks wherein the yale were the principal element. A simplification of the time in function of the place can be found in the same sentence in reality in Yenikoi, In Kosovo, with the land net plan of the Ottoman Venice to water side building, this structure occupies a very narrow lot and has a limited overlook on the sea, although it's sensitive to the scale and the character of the traditional layout. Distributed on four levels, the plan of the house is an interpretation in the modern care of the architecture of the nearby village of Arnancoy of Quebec, where the Yale and the Bosso were not necessarily villa, but also the home of fishermen. Well, the term herein became the grand core resolved on different levels, which passed through the house from the road down to the seafront. The image which derived from it, that view on the sea which had such allure for the traveler on the Bosphorus, is a light gesture, an architecture which holds together various histories, visiting facade and characters of the spontaneous architecture, linked here in a modern language with some reference to loss. In every season, at every hour, the Yale rests as happy family in a city which today is not only in a serene transformation. Thank you very much.
It is written in the history, not the ones that dream.
it's written that the one that made that death come true, that dreams come true.
Сейчас все, кто вы ели и в чате берешь Паулу, Масла и Дарью Зеленович, Дарью Зеленович.
It's a new era, it's the beginning of a new era for the construction sector. It's Паулу, Масла.
Так, Паулу, Елю Зеленович.
Okay. So our paper is called Home for Home, and I began with Maslak project of Aulu. That's the name of the constructor you see. It's a very famous popular man in Turkey. And I began with this project because, you know, the social life is an exchange of meanings interpreted from images, like images we saw all around us. And this is a pre-designed process by architects and their companies, and as architectural products are converted to meanings by the perceiver according to the images they represent. And this owl man is selling out the image of 1453, like it's the year that Mehmet II conquered Istanbul, Constantinople, and now and started a new era. And he's like selling us the image of that the conqueror. So we today in the media we see a lot of these commercials. They're always like residential projects with shopping malls and everything, offices maybe sometimes. So these two projects were from the Varia company, Varia Meridian and Metropole Istanbul, this one. And we had Trump Towers and Mall of Istanbul. We like, you know, see these commercials every day, like 5 times. They have their songs and everything. And I can sing the songs. That's how much we see these commercials. So mainly in Turkey right now, the housing markets are ruled by these companies and commercials. So there are two main discussions about these projects of homes and residents. One of them is they're not related to our culture. They don't have an identity and they don't connect with our social memory. The second discussion about these houses or projects are the problem with their function and facade relationship. They're not readability by the observers. These two conditions cause problems. So we know that when the observer encounters these types of building, it's impossible to read what's in it, what's the function. If they're all made of metal and glass, they're always the same forms, like, you know, big high towers. So it is discussed that the observers, the users, get confused and give a response that I call Superman response when they see these buildings. You know the story, they see the Superman for the first time and they say, look up in the sky, it's a bird, it's a plane, no, it's Superman. And then these people come across one of these buildings and say, look at this new building, it's a shopping mall, no, it's an office. No, it's a multifunctional high-rise block, so, you know, you don't know what it is in it, but you can do so many things, so it's so prestigious, and you should buy one of these. So, it's kind of the case, you know, how it's discussed right now. So, we ask here some questions that was this always the case with these problems? How was this function and facade relationship in Turkey used to be, and what were the images used during whole housing process? So we will have a quick look on the housing culture in Turkey, like for 100 years almost, and we will begin with traditional houses, which you've seen at the beginning of the session at the other paper, so I will pass quickly. This is from Saframulu. These houses are formed geometrically using repetitive and symmetric rectangular elements, window, jumbas, bay window, as opposed to kma, and door and window frames and eaves. This is from Chaton. This is from Çamlıca, southern Turkey. So this was the case during whole Ottoman period until like 1920s. When we come to the 20s, we see that the acceptance of Republican government in 1923, Turkey began to be reshaped with the ideal of Atatürk's revolution as a modern country and a new identity. So architects produced a Turkish national architecture style, and which like formed the country nearly 30 years as a first and second Turkish national architecture style. And the forms was like this. They used symmetrical plans, symmetrical elevations, rhythmical window configurations, plain or hidden high-deep slant roofs, and cone configurations, configuration in the entrance. And these characteristics were taken from the national architectural style and adopted here. We see two famous buildings of Mimar Kemalettin, which is he and Berat Tek from First National Architectural Style together, and this was the case like for 30 years. And when we come to the 50s, we see that architects began to search what's new and care less about the national references. Western styles like purism and brutalism began to dominate, and during this period, we see that government failed to supply the housing needs, and so we see squatters began to shape like everywhere in Turkey, mostly big cities first, but then everywhere, and squatter areas began to be a problem, and by the time the government started a method that had been contracted by the Turkish Republic Real Estate Bank, that residential areas are shaped and constructed with this bank. And this is one of the districts they constructed, the 4-8-4, that's still, this building is still used. And the others, this is a cooperative for the lawyers, they did with this cooperative. And then the first satellite town outside Ankara is Oran Public Housing Settlement. It's done by the government. And after apartments and the social housings, when we come to the 80s, we see something different. That is, during the 80s, postmodern style affected architecture in Turkey, and houses, of course, history, tradition, and rhetoric, iconography, color, convention, sculpture, and all of this anything was style gained importance with postmodernism, also in Turkey. Elements of history and the principle of unprincipledness were combined, and traditional architecture was a repertory for forms and symbols for this architecture. Pottery trends and Western origin materials are used heavily and in a very colorful way, as you see. These are some villas and houses. Designed by famous architects of that time. You see the similarity with the traditional architecture, but in a postmodern way. when it comes to 80s. So, we come here and see the Housing Development Administration of Turkey. It's a legal entity, and it's established by the government to meet the housing needs of low-income groups. And now it's announced that this administration builds almost 25% of all housing in Turkey every year. So this is how much they do houses for us. They build houses. This project is from Konya. It's like they do these kind of buildings everywhere in